माय डियर स्टूडेंट, लेट अस सी ये कॉम्प्लिकेटेड प्रॉब्लम, न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ एंड हॉर्स कार्ट प्रॉब्लम। अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन, वी नो दैट टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन। टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ। एवरी एक्शन इज इक्वल टू रिएक्शन। टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन। एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन दिस विल बी इक्वल बट इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, बट बोथ एक्ट्स ऑन two different bodies. Now, if action is equal to reaction, then how the cart will be pulled by the horse? If horse applies the force on the cart, cart will also apply the same force on the horse. Then how it is possible to pull the cart? I am going to explain that thing. Newton's third law is also given in the previous video, but here for the summary I have written here. So we are considering here horse cart problem. This is cart and this is horse. So with the help of the rope, cart is attached with the horse. What will happen? Weight of the cart will be along downward direction. This is weight of the cart, and which is known as action on the ground. So reaction will be on the cart. According to Newton's third law, action and reaction acts on two different bodies. Action will be on the ground and reaction will be on the cart. But action is not more than the reaction is not more than the action. So it will be on the ground and it will be balanced. Now come to this point. So if a horse applies force along this direction, this will be action. This will be action. So cart will also apply force on the horse along this direction. This will be called as reaction. So action by the cart and the reaction on the cart will be equal to reaction applied on the cart. Action is done by the horse. So action by the horse, here we can write here action by the horse and reaction on the cart by reaction on the cart. So here you can see action by the horse. Action by the horse and reaction is applied on the horse by the cart. These two will be same, equal and opposite, so it will be same and according to Newton's third law. Now come to on the horse. Weight of horse is along downward direction. Now to pull the cart, horse applies force on the ground and this is called as action. This is called as action of horse on the ground. Action of horse on the ground. Action of horse on the ground. And the reaction will be on the horse by the ground. This is R. R can be taken, its value will be 2 along horizontal and along upward. So this is the reaction in horizontal and this component is reaction in the vertical direction. This reaction in vertical direction balances the weight of the horse. Reaction in the vertical direction balances the weight of the horse. But this part remains free. It is not balanced by anyone. Here it is internal force. सिस्टम के इंटरनल फोर्स का कोई असर नहीं होता है. इफ़ वी आर on the bus and we want to pull the bus and we are on the bus, so many people can push the bus, but bus will not be pushed because you are the part of the system. Here action and reaction by the horse and cart is internal system. It will not affect the motion of the system. These two will also not affect the motion of the system. But here we can say this is balanced by vertical component of the reaction is balanced by weight of the horse, and only RH, this is the reaction in horizontal direction, it will be free. It is not balanced by anything. So this component of force is responsible to pull the cart along the horizontal direction. So this is the how the cart is pulled by the horse. Okay, thank you.